Hello, my name is Mohammad Istiaq Hussain Khan. My student number is 208221. The name of the paper I am presenting is Enhanced Biomass Production Through Optimization of Carbon Source and Utilization of Wastewater as a Nutrient Source. The content of my presentation are research background, introduction, materials and method, result and discussion and conclusion. Research background. Utilize the domestic wastewater as nutrient feedstock. C. vulgaris showed higher increment of biomass and biomass productivity. The biomass accumulated 19.29% total lipid, 41.4% carbohydrate and 33.06% proteins. Glucose supplemented wastewater removed 96.9% chemical oxygen demand, 65.3% total nitrogen and 71.2% total phosphate. The fatty acid methyl ester showed higher amount of, which is nearly 61.94% of saturated fatty acid methyl. Introduction. The microalga C. vulgaris was cultivated in different types of organic cigars to identify the prime carbon source. Suitable organic carbon was determined to augment biomass production in wastewater. Effect on removal of total nitrogen, total phosphate and CO2 was also evaluated under optimized condition and wastewater. Finally, a scale-up study was performed in 3L photobioreactor. Materials and method. Here, table 1 represents the characteristics of raw wastewater used in the experiment. The ratio of chemical oxygen demand, total nitrogen and total phosphorus was excessive for the wastewater treatment system but is recommended for nutrient removal in activated slash plants. Similarly, the biochemical oxygen demand and total phosphorus as well as BOD5 and PO4 ratios were found to be reasonably high. Also, the PO4 and TP ratio was at higher range for municipal wastewater system. In the analytical procedure, the growth of biomass productivity, pigment, total nitrogen, total phosphate and COD lipid content, GCMS analysis, FEM conversion and carbohydrate and protein content are analyzed. Result and discussion. In figure 1, the effect of various organic carbon sources on biomass growth of pigment are described. Figure 1 shows the biomass growth of C. vulgaris cultivated in wastewater in different carbon sources. Glucose was most readily consumed by C. vulgaris. The maximal cell density of 1.23 GBL was achieved using glucose and acetate. In figure 2b, specific growth rate of glucose plus glycerol and glucose plus acetate, suggesting that glucose consumption was more efficient in promoting cell growth than the other two carbon sources tested. In figure 1c displays the highest amount of chlorophyll was attained in glucose and acetate supplemented culture. In figure 2, effect of glucose concentration on biomass productivity and pigment is given. In figure 2a, the highest amount of biomass of 1.23 dry cell weight was observed in wastewater supplemented with 5 GL glucose. Similarly, in figure 2b, the highest biomass productivity of 0.0196 was achieved in wastewater supplemented with 5 GL glucose as compared to 0.031 GL/D in control condition. In figure 2c, the highest amount of chlorophyll and carotenoid was obtained in control. The total pigment increased with addition of glucose. In figure 3, the effect of glucose concentration on total nitrogen and total phosphate removal is given. As shown in figure 3, the highest total nitrogen removal of 58.1% was observed in wastewater supplemented with 5 GL glucose. However, the increasing of glucose concentration above 5 GL did not significantly increase the total nitrogen removal. In figure 3b, the maximal total phosphorus removal efficiency of 74.8% was observed in wastewater supplemented with 5 GL glucose. In figure 4, the effect of glucose concentration on COD removal is given. The high COD removal of 96.9% was observed in wastewater supplemented with 5 GL glucose due to rapid biomass growth and glucose assimilation. A 75.8% COD removal was achieved in control, suggesting that microalgal cells were able to uptake nutrients present in wastewater. The amount of COD removal was calculated and found to increase from 1552 mg by G to 8171 mg by G dCW while increasing the glucose concentration from 2 to 30 mg by L. In settled and diluted wastewater cultivated by C. vulgaris, where the decrease in initial COD concentration from 1000 mg per L to 250 mg per liter caused a remarkable increase in COD removal percentage from 20.6% to 88%. In Figure 5, the variation of glucose on microalgal biochemical composition is given. The highest carbohydrate content of 40.18% was observed in wastewater supplemented with 10 gram per liter glucose. Similarly, protein content was increased up to 36.2% in wastewater supplemented with 10 gram per liter glucose. Almost 85% of biotransformed to lipid and polysaccharide and only 1% occurs as free glucose. In Figure 6, the scale up study is given. As shown in Figure 6a, the under control light and temperature condition C. vulgaris do better in 5 gram per liter glucose supplemented wastewater than in the control. The total nitrogen removal of and total phosphate exponentially increase until 6 day and stabilize thereafter in a stationary phase are given in Figure 6b. In Figure 6c, the biochemical screening of biomass showed accumulation of 41.4% carbohydrate, 33.06% protein and 19.29% crude lipids. The fatty acid methyl ester composition obtained from the crude lipid are presented in Table 2. Saturated fatty acid comprises to 61.94% of total and unsaturated fatty acid comprises the remaining 38.06%. Among the unsaturated fatty acid, monounsaturated fatty acid were observed to comprise 26.03% of the total lipid, while polyunsaturated fatty acid comprised 12.03%. Oleic acid abundance of 17.40% was observed in the scale-up study, suggesting that the fame obtained were potentially favorable production of biodiesel. Moreover, noticeable fraction of myristic acid, palmitic acid and stearic acid were also observed, which is largely believed to augment and quality and improve performance of biodiesel. In the conclusion section, we can say that among the various carbon source and concentration tested, 5 gram per liter glucose supplementation of wastewater was the optimized condition that yielded higher biomass, lipid, protein and carbohydrate. Algal cultivation under the optimized condition removed 65.3% of total nitrogen, 71.2% total phosphate and 96.9% COD, 41.14% carbohydrate, 36.03% protein and 19.23% crude lipid are usually fatty acid like oleic, stearic and eicosapentaenoic acid, demonstrating potential human, animal and agriculture application. Thank you. Please like and comment in this video and please subscribe to the YouTube channel.